And that gives you that snatch, like, I just got a Maserati or whatever it's called. Maserati Botox. I'm definitely saying that wrong, but you know what I meant. Hi guys, today I have a makeup tutorial for you guys on how I achieved this super glowy, almost animated eye makeup routine. This has been like a highly sought out routine. You guys have been DMing me like, I want an updated routine, I want an updated routine. You guys already know, I had to give it to you. Thank you guys so freaking much for all the love that you have been giving me, especially on my last vid and on my TikTok and on my Instagram. I can't believe we have like almost 22K on the video that was posted 2 days ago. That's like absolutely wild to me. But thank you guys so much. And we're at 6K now. And you guys know that I've mentioned in my last video that I wanted to have 10K by the end of the month. And I really think we can do that. And you guys surpassed the thumbs up goal by like so much. I wanted to only have like 100 thumbs up. You guys have like, you guys did it to like 2,000. We have 2,000 thumbs up. So you guys are amazing. So I think for today, I think we could do 3,000 thumbs up. Because we did 2,000 last time. And I'm going to give you a big number. We can do 3,000 this time. And yeah, let's get straight into this video. Oh yeah, I also forgot to tell you guys to subscribe. But yeah, subscribe to me immediately. Because I give so many fun tips. And you want to know all the fun tips. I want to stress this so much, but what you do before you put on your makeup is so important. Your moisturizer routine is literally what's going to give you that like glowy glass skin. So we're going to be using 3 products today. 2 of them are the same. I just got the mini version and I use this specifically for my under eye. The first product I'm going to be using is the COSRX, or whatever it's pronounced. It's a Korean skincare brand, but their hyaluronic acid cream. I feel like this is like a really deep moisturizer, more than a serum. It's definitely more of a moisturizer than a serum, but I like to just put it all over and my lips. My lips are so dry right now, it's so embarrassing, but really rub that all into your skin just like this. And make sure you get your neck, because we are going to be putting a tiny bit of makeup on my neck today. Because I have some acne scars, like right here. I got like really bad pimples on my neck. I think it was because I was putting that stupid amber oil musk that I love so much, but it breaks me out like crazy. And I would put it on my neck and I would put it on my wrists. But like for some reason, my neck is really prone to acne. So we have to fix that. But like, look at how glowy my skin already looks just with one product, but we want it to look super glowy before we put our makeup on. So the next product I'm gonna be using is this Laneige Sleeping Mask. It is just so deeply moisturizing. I have gone through about 5 of these in the last 2 months just because I use so much of it. Yes, it's a sleeping mask. I kind of like it as a base for my primer just because it gives you this like really good just plump feeling on your face, and it's really good for your under eyes. But I got the mini version because I've just been using this so much, so I'm like, let me get the mini version just for my under eyes because I don't need to use that much. But like, oh, is this even gonna open? I feel like it's not. I feel like it's gonna take forever for me to open this. Okay, so now that we have it, we're gonna just put this under our under eye because that is what's gonna give you that like soft, perfect, no creasing, no bags look when you put your concealer and your powder on. But our base routine is done, and now we can really get into this makeup. This may be super weird, but I really like to set my eyebrows with lash glue just because I have the curliest eyebrows and they always just go do their own thing and nothing has made them stay. And don't even try to tell me, ooh, try this type of putty, try soap brows, all of that. No, girl. Nothing stayed. I've even used edge control on my eyebrows and it just made me break out, not gonna lie. It made me break out like right here. And I've used the whole e.l.f. like eyebrow putty. I've used the Charlotte Tilbury one and those are nice, but they don't make my eyebrows stay through thick and thin. Like this lash glue, I like to use the super strong hold lash glue by Adele. I got it on Amazon. It came with like 2 packs of like the light one and then a black one. So I use this for my eyelashes and then this for my eyebrows. it really eats every single time. Because you have to move so quickly, because if you don't shape them in time, they will just stay in place. It's actually super scary. There's been multiple occasions where my eyebrows have looked so fucked up because I didn't get to the shaping in time, and then they just stayed in this weird ass shape the entire time. My favorite primer to use right now is this Milk Cosmetics Hydro Grip one. I've used all the different dupes, and I'm sorry, I still like the Milk one more. So hear me out. With the e.l.f. dupe, I feel like it's almost too tacky, and it low-key made the rest of my makeup peel. And yes, I've used other makeup products that were like silicone based to make it all match up and work, but still, it just was too tacky for me and I just did not like it. But the only dupe, I guess, that I've liked compared to this one is definitely, sorry, my drawer's kind of messy, but this NYX Plump Right Back one is super good. This has like the same consistency, but it doesn't work as good as this, but this is still good. So if you are broke and need like a good dupe, try the NYX Plump Right Back Up. I think I got this at like CVS or something. I decided to do my lashes off camera just because it's kind of an annoying process to show, because I basically just cut my inner corners and then just shape them to be the size that I want. But I use these lashes. They're from Amazon. I'll link them for you guys. But I just want to get into the actual makeup routine because I feel like I'm stalling right now. My holy grail to having like the most glowiest, shiniest skin with my makeup is to combine this L'Oreal Glotion, the darkest color, and then this Fenty Beauty, it's their Ease Droplet Bronzing whatever, but I'll show you what it looks like in a second. But this together with the L'Oreal makes my skin looks so good. Like, look at that. It's like a serum. I wouldn't even consider this makeup because it's not shiny enough. I mean, like, it doesn't have like the sparkles and stuff to be a highlighter, but this is like amazing to put before your foundation or your tinted moisturizer because it just makes your skin look so healthy. And especially with like the moisturizing before that, like, you're girl, bye. Your skin's about to look so freaking good. And I don't know, I low-key be catfishing with this. Like, on a no makeup day, I go and just wear this and then I'll put mascara on and people think that I have like the craziest, most amazing skin. And I use about this much of the L'Oreal stuff. My skin looks so shiny right now. But so for my foundations, I like to use the e.l.f. Halo Glows, and I use shade 6 and then shade 7. Everybody needs to start like mixing your foundations and your tinted moisturizers because sometimes you can't find your perfect match, and I don't think that's a reason to give up and try to find a new product. You can definitely make it work by just mixing products together. And this kind of gives you a nice bronze look if you do a darker shade. But I use about this much on my entire face, and I've switched over from using solely beauty blenders and all that back to brushes just because I have found that I get a lot more of a full coverage look when I use brushes. And that's really helpful if you have acne scars or any dark like hyperpigmentation, because you're actually using every single bit of the product that you put on your face. Whereas when you put a beauty blender with your makeup, it kind of like soaks up all that product. Also, this eyebrow looks kind of fucked up. I need to fix that in a second. So this step isn't needed, but I like to do it just because I have two like acne scars on my cheeks and I want to get rid of them. I know you guys can't see it really well on this camera, but I use this Morphe concealer. I think it's discontinued. So fun story about this concealer, I found it in my mom's closet because I'm a little thief and I love to go through my mom's closet and just steal things. And she's definitely gonna see this. My mom watches all my videos. But thank you, Mom. It smells like alcohol though and paint, which is kind of scary, but it does the job. But you have to blend it out immediately because it dries so freaking fast and it's kind of matte, and I don't want an entire matte look. So just blend it out really, really fast. And I put it like right here around my nose and under my eye just to give my concealer a good base. And once again, this is not a needed step. You don't need to have this. I do this just because it gives my skin that extra and like filter look. So I'm gonna do it every single time. But please, Mom, don't get mad at me. You have a bunch of fun products in your closet and I just cannot help but take them from you. And I don't know what the fuck you were gonna do. Sorry that I sweared. But I don't know what you're going to do with something this dark. Like, come on now. Your skin not that dark. You don't need all that. I finally switched from using the Born This Way Too Faced Concealer to just the Maybelline one. And I heard that I'm going to get hyper attached to this. And I definitely am already, just because it just eats every single time. And it doesn't make me break out. Like, I was such a huge Too Faced concealer fan, but that shit was really breaking me out, guys. Like, let me chill out with the swearing. I need to stop. Guys, comment how many times I swear, because I'm really trying to work on it. It makes me, like, really not ladylike, and I'm trying to be better, and my family watches this, and I don't want them to know I swear this much. I need to chill out. I feel like everybody knows this trick already, but you have to let your concealer sit, girl. You cannot be blending them out immediately after you put it on your face, because it's just not going to get that full coverage look. And obviously we're going for that natural glowing, like I woke up with like glaze everywhere. I was dipped into a freaking pool of oil, but we still need to let it sit. So I'm going to set my face a little bit right now. And look what I have. I have this fun little gadget. Don't play. I look so freaking good, and it's making my hair wave. But definitely get one of these. If you want to feel like such a baddie while doing your makeup, don't get the fan. Don't get that stupid little plastic fan. Get yourself one of these fans, and you can get it in all types of colors. I used to have a pack of like 7 of these, and people were stealing it from me just because they look so good whipping it out and just fanning their face. And I would take this to parties with me, guys. I look like such a baddie doing this. Like, it's so funny. But yeah, just like dry out your concealer so you don't have to wait as long. So contour is so important. I used to use this Fenty espresso stick contour stick or whatever, but you guys bullied me on TikTok and was like, this is like not dark enough for you. And I didn't want to go out and buy a new one. So I had this in my drawer, and it's another Fenty product, but it's a concealer, and it's basically just a super dark concealer that I use as contour. So use a little tiny amount right there. Actually, I'm gonna use this for my face because it still works for my face. So we're gonna put this on my face, the contour stick, like that. And this is where I like to place my contour, just like that. But under is really important. So you don't wanna do it here, you wanna do it here. And then bring it up to your ear. Under there, and bring it up to your ear, like that. And that gives you that snatch, like I just got a Maserati or whatever it's called, Maserati Botox. I'm definitely saying that wrong, but you know what I meant. You know what I meant. The Botox that gives you like the buckle fat remover look. Yeah, buckle fat remover Botox DIY at home. That's how you do it. And then you're gonna get a brush like this, and you're gonna take this concealer, and you need to be very careful with this step. This is my nose contour routine that's going to snatch your nose to the gods. And it's what's his name? Patrick Ta's routine. And a little mix of mine. So you're gonna start up here really gently. Really, really gently. You do not want it to be too dark up there. It's gonna look like a weird line, and you're gonna look like your eyebrows are all messed up. But we're gonna create like a false bone structure. And we're gonna gently pull it down and bring it under the nose like that. And this is where you can like add a little bit of more heaviness to your brush to get more of the product. But go under like that and snatch it like this. Do you see what I'm doing? Hopefully you can see what I'm doing. And then you wanna move back up, but be gentle again. Don't do too much, girl. I know you're trying to do too much. Don't do it. You're gonna look crazy, okay? And then you're gonna move it gently under your eyebrow. And when I say gently, emphasis on gently, because I know you like to like put a heavy hand on that, but that's why you're walking around looking like a crazy person and a clown, because you're putting too much of a heavy hand when doing that contour, so chill out. And then with the whatever products left on your brush, you're gonna put it on the tip of your nose like that. And now you have like this cute button nose look, period. And now we just have to blend all of this out. So for my concealer, I'm gonna be using a brush like this. And then I think I wanna use this brush too. So I use brushes and then a little bit, if I'm feeling it, I use a beauty blender. But I try to avoid using that beauty blender because it picks up my makeup too much. And then for my contour, I'm gonna be using this brush to blend out everything. But let's just get straight into it. Sometimes it's really hard to blend out the contour on your face, and this is when I go in with my foundation brush and I just kind of put foundation over it. It makes it like, it confirms that I will not be having any lines when I walk out the house, but it does kind of fade the contour, but it's not too bad, but it's okay. You see what I'm talking about the like whole Maserati Botox look? Like, look how snatched it looks. Hold on, does that even look blended? Girl, bye. That's not even blended for real. My bad. I use this type of brush to blend out my contour. Okay, so all my makeup's blended, but I want to add a little bit more of this Fenty Glow stuff just because we do want that glaze donut look. But I'm gonna use a different brush this time. Got something stuck in my throat, but I'm gonna use this brush. This is technically for your body, but I like to use it as just like an all-around blend and mesh everything together. Some people might like it, some people might not, but I like to do this just because it makes my makeup look really freaking good. But yeah, put this all over your face, add some to your neck, and I did forget to add my concealer. But we need to add some concealer right here on my neck. And where's my little blending brush? This is one of my blending brushes, so we're gonna use that. And then conceal those pimples that were on my neck. And then go over it with this brush. So now, this will even pick up any like leftover contour that was not fully blended out. And now our face looks so glowy and we can move on to the next step. My blush routine is literally elite because I mix my blushes. You need to hop on that, girl. It's so much fun. But I mix the Rare Beauty blush, which is shade Grateful. And then this is another Rare Beauty dupe. And it's the Milani Kiss Cheek blush. And this is shade Berry Cooch. Smooch, not cooch, bye. And I put it right under and it creates this like ombre effect with your blush, and it's so, so beautiful. I think I want to add a little bit of setting spray to my face before I blend all of this out, just because the Rare Beauty, it dries up so fast, girl. It's like terrible. But quickly blend this out and get it under your eye, like right here. Like, get it really under your eye. It looks so pretty, especially when you set it with your powder, like this just like pink under eye look, but not all the way up to here, just the ends. You want to make it pink, like you're blushing, and you could smile a little, but I don't do all the smiling just because I don't like the huge blush, like that looks like too much to me. But you're gonna just like do this a little bit and then pull it up and kind of into your hairline. I get what I'm saying? I think it's so cute though. I'm literally obsessed. God, I love blush. And you want to just keep blending it out until you don't look like a clown, basically. Because when it comes to the Rare Beauty blushes, it's gonna have you looking crazy if you do not blend it out properly. And then this is like just a me thing. You don't have to do this, but I feel like it gives me that button nose look and it's so cute. But I put a tiny bit of the blush under my nose. I just got some on my nose, yo. butt, and you just put it right there, and I don't know, it just adds this like kind of like, oh, I'm cold, like warm me up look. I just love it, and people compliment me all the time about it. So yeah, and that's all for the blush. It looks so cute, look at it. And you see how it's like blended, it doesn't look too red, too pink. It's like perfectly in my skin tone. You can even bring it down a little bit if you don't like a dramatic transition, but I think it's like perfectly blended for now. Setting powder is so important, especially when you want your makeup to stay all day when you're going to school or a party. So I like to mix mine. I just hopped on to Huda Beauty. They don't play. They do not play at all. Huda Beauty, you did that, girl. And they're so inclusive. Like, they have like every color and I love it. And this setting powder is literally my skin tone. When I tell you, when I tried it out at the store, I was like, damn, girl. It doesn't even look like I have anything on my face. But I mix it with the Laura Mercier, and you're gonna see why. But I start off with this one, but I use like not that much. I gently put it on because it is very cakey. So just put it really right here, like where your eye bag is the heaviest, the most. And then when you have already put on your face, you want to get another brush, like a fluffier one, fluff it out some more, and kind of like pat it off your face. Because we do not want that super cake matte look. We just want our under eyes to be set and good. Notice how I haven't put it anywhere else on my face. Just because this is more of an everyday makeup look. If I was going out to like a club, I would definitely set under here, but we don't gotta do all that. This is literally just for school, just to look sexy, to go get our mail. Like, this is what this makeup's for. And then now we're gonna use the Laura Mercier. Also, for the shade for Huda Beauty, I use shade Coffee Cake. And then Laura Mercier, the translucent powder, I use shade medium deep. And you wanna be really gentle with this. So we're gonna use a brush, I think. Yeah, I'm gonna use a brush. Which brush do I wanna use? Okay, I'm gonna use this brush. It's like this angled brush. And we're gonna get a little tiny bit of it, tap it off, and we're gonna put it right here. This is for if you want that like brighter under eye look, cause this is the darkest shade, but it's not that dark. Notice how it's still bright under my eye. And you see that shape that I've created under my eye? You want to do the same thing right there. And then with the same brush that you use to blend out the Huda Beauty one, you want to tap that one off too. And doing this technique with your powder is going to also give you that like snatch nose look. It just brings everything together. It looks so good. So just blend all of that out. Like, do you see how smooth my under eye looks? Don't play. I have those massive bags. I know you guys saw it. Where are my bags now? Where are my bags now? I'm gonna pretend it's like not like 2 a.m. right now, but like, where are my bags? Nowhere, exactly. So now that we're completely done with our base makeup look, we're going to completely set our face. I like to use a Charlotte Tilbury spray because it does not play. It does not make my makeup move. It stays on all day long, and it's that girl. I love her so much. I'm about to actually get the Charlotte Tilbury under eye powder because I use my friend's, and hers is way lighter than mine, right? Like, she's Arab, so her skin color obviously is not gonna work, but somehow the Charlotte Tilbury setting powder for hers, it worked perfectly with me. So I'm buying it in that exact shade too. It was like shade medium, but look, it looks perfect, and my skin looks so glowy right now. But it doesn't look too much. It doesn't look like I put a bunch of highlighter on my face. It just looks like my skin hit like a really good spot day, and I just really like that look. It's so freaking cute. But we need to move on and do my lip routine. This is the lip liner I use. I'm gonna get in trouble, but this is my friend's. I like to use NYX Cold Brew. That's also good. But my friend, this is my NYX Cold Brew. It's almost gone. But my friend got this huge packet of lip liners, right? And she doesn't use this one, but I had borrowed it, and then it was in my bag because we were all like going through our stuff, but it ended up in my bag. But this is hers, and I will be returning it, and I will be buying my own. But it's very, very good, and I like it a lot. It's from Amazon, and it was like, it's Nabi Hot Cocoa. I don't know what brand this is, but it's from Amazon, and she got like 30 of these for like $20. So I need it, but I like to start with my lip liner up here I like my lips to look massive, but not too massive. So when lining your lips, you want to look for like the non-pigmented part of your lip, where you're not overlining necessarily, but it's the part where your lip is there, it just doesn't have much color, and that is what you want to line. So for me, it's like that area right here, and then that area, and then the same down here. It's a little bit dark. Help. We're gonna need to use a little brush and fix that. So we're gonna use this brush. No, that's a highlighter brush. We're gonna use this brush. And then we're gonna try to blend out that liner so it doesn't look too dark. Cause we don't wanna look like we're walking around with lip liner. We want to look like we have a bunch of lip filler, but we're broke. So we're gonna have to make do with what we got. So we're gonna do this. Okay. Perfect. Now that that is the color that I want it to be, I'm gonna go in with a little bit of lotion. Where's it at? Here it is. But I'm gonna go in with my Laneige lotion, and this is such a good tip, girl, because every time I wear it and I kiss somebody, they're like, oh my god, your lips are so soft. Like, I've never kissed somebody with lips this soft as you. And I'm like, boy, what hooligans are you kissing? What hooligans are you kissing? Because every girl's lips should be nice and pumpy and soft before they're gonna kiss somebody. Like, be for real. But anyways, that's what you wanna do. So for the next step, I like to use my Juvia's Place palette. Palette number 5, volume 5. And I take a brush, and then you see this like dark pink color. I take this color, hold on, Nip Slip, and we're going to just gently put it on our lip. And yes, you're probably thinking, Anna, this is gonna dry on my lip, like it's not gonna look good. Yes, it will. Trust me, it will not dry out your lip, and it's gonna look good because we're gonna moisturize it and we're gonna put lip gloss. It's gonna be okay. Trust the process. This just looks super natural. Like, doesn't this look like my natural lip, but better? Don't play. And then we're gonna go in with a little bit more lip liner, but not too much. Once again, be careful with the heavy hand. This looks so good. And sometimes I like to add a little bit of a line right here, just to add that like Sarah Cameron lip look. God, I want her lips so freaking bad. She's literally the reason why I might get like lip filler, that ass, even though I don't need it. But I just really like that look. It's so cute. And then let me find the lip liners I want to use. Not the lip liners, lip glosses. I know I want to use this lip gloss. And then I want to use my broken ghetto Fenty lip gloss. I just realized you guys got to see my nails up close and personal, and that's really embarrassing for me. But whatever. So these are the lip glosses I like to use. So I think I want to start off with this Fruit Fetish blush by, what brand is this? Milani. And shade 120 Strawberry Melon. And this, I don't want to use too much of it because it's very pink. This is just for like a light gloss. Lightly put that on. And then you want to go with your Fenty one. I'm like almost gone. I have to do this. And this just adds dimension. I'm really big on, when it comes to my lip, adding dimension and color. Like, I like to mix things up. I like to use multiple different combinations just so it looks so cute. And look at my lip. Like, it just looks so cute right now. Ugh, I look so good. Now that I feel like Kylie Jenner with the biggest, fattest, juiciest lip on planet Earth, we can do my final and second favorite step. Because I keep calling everything my favorite stuff. But let's go find this palette first. It's my, where is this palette? I swear, guys, I lose everything, so just stay with me. But this palette eats, okay? But specifically for this and their little highlighter. But this, it's so dark and it's perfect. But I use this shape brush. Do you see what I'm talking about? It's like this. But I use a flat brush, and then I take this product and you want to be careful with this. So this is how I do my eyeliner. This is like my OG method, because I used to just use a normal eyeliner, but this just makes it look better. But so you want to go straight, but you want to find the end of your eye. So my end is right there, and I want to go straight out. Same thing, straight out. And this gives you this like doe eye look, and it's so freaking pretty. So there's our line. There's our line. We're gonna add a little bit more powder, and then we're gonna just blend that in. It's gonna look a little wonky, but we're gonna add normal eyeliner and it's all gonna blend in together. So you see how we kind of made like a weird V shape? Not V, like triangle shape. Add a little bit more, and don't be afraid to go down a little bit. Just don't make yourself look like a raccoon girl. And if you're too nervous to do it with this brush, just do it with an eyeliner, because trust, you will mess it up. You will mess it up if you do not know how to do it right, and it's gonna look very scary, and you're gonna be very, very upset. So then now I like to use my Maybelline eyeliner. This is my go-to eyeliner. Look at it, it's all messed up looking. But I take this, and then I go over my lash line. And guys, I kind of like a messier eyeliner look. Like, it's not gonna be perfect, but my lashes cover it half the time. So just kind of make that line. I go like a little bit on my inner corner, just a little bit. Like that. And then that's when we're gonna make that shape. You see how it's like perfect now? It doesn't look all wonky. I'm gonna do the same thing on this side. There we go. Perfect. And now our eyes look like this. This is like my method. It looks good on me. I don't know like how you guys are gonna feel about it, but it eats for me, and I'm gonna keep doing it. So do not come for me in the comments, because I know my eyeliner is very controversial, because it looks a little weird sometimes, but it really does eat, guys. Or maybe I'm just gaslighting myself, I don't know. But so now I go in with my NYX Jumbo Stick white eyeliner, and I literally put it at just the ends. Like that. Do you see what I'm talking about? Like, and I know what you're thinking, Anna, like, that's white right there. We're gonna fix it. Don't worry, girl. So we're gonna go back in with my eyeliner, and we're gonna find where that white looks a little wonky. Hold on, I just messed up low-key. We have to fix this. Oh my god, we're having a makeup demo. Okay, we're gonna go in with some mascara. Mascara has always come to the rescue when it comes to hold on. I'm low-key going blind right now, guys. We're having a makeup dilemma. Okay, we're good now. So we're just gonna add more mascara right here. This is low-key a really bold look for your eye, but I really just wanted to show you guys my eyeliner routine. I would definitely not wear this to school. I mean, you can, but it's definitely not meant for school. Your eyes just look so big. I think it looks so pretty. Okay. We are done with my eyes. This is the finished makeup look. I hope that you guys liked it and that I explained everything properly. But I would definitely wear this two and every day, just go into the store. Maybe not the eyeliner, I'd probably just do the lashes. But my base routine, like, it looks perfect. My lips are eating right now. I look so good. If you try it out, definitely take a picture of it and send it to me, because yeah, I want to see all of that. But comment what other type of content you want to see from me on here and on TikTok. And yeah, I really liked making this for you guys. And I will see you guys, I don't know when, because you know how I be. I'm not very consistent, but I'm trying to be. All right, bye guys.